This is the first bilateral visit after 9 years. Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh last visited in 2006. He was also there in 2009 for the G20 summit. Now, this is an important visit for a number of reasons. I think most of you would agree that the UK is a major power with considerable global influence. And engaging such a power is obviously important in foreign policy. It is a member of the Security Council, a permanent member of the Security Council, of the EU, of the G8, of the G20, of the NATO, of the important export control regimes of the OECD. And so that gives you a sense of the kind of issues which could come up in the political discussions. Secondly, the UK is also the city of London. It's a very important financial center at a time when we are seeking to attract capital and technology and best practices from abroad. The investment and economic aspects of this visit will be very important. The diaspora aspect. We have the second largest Indian diaspora in the UK. Persons of Indian origin are roughly about 1.5 million. We also have more than 3 lakh NRIs resident in UK. They broadly constitute 2% of the UK population. They are well represented politically as well. You have 10 MPs of Indian origin, 24 peers of Indian origin. So there's the diaspora aspect. Then there is the modern UK, the more, you know, the science and technology UK, the clean technology UK. UK is among our top 5 S&T partners. We have a number of joint research, innovation and collaboration programs. We have 20,000 students there. And it's actually, for Indian students, it is probably after the US the second choice in going abroad. So there is that aspect. In fact, on the people-to-people side, please bear in mind as well that our tourism links with UK are very, very important. We get more than 10 lakh tourists from UK, 4 lakh Indians visit UK annually. And finally, it is a country with whom we have obviously a very special history, very unique bonds. We share a number of institutions and values. These are all, I would say, this in a sense is the backdrop for the visit. Now, in terms of our PM and PM Cameron, this would be the third meeting. They met at the Brisbane G20 last year. They met then this year in September at the UNGA. PM Cameron himself has visited India thrice, and he has spoken, both he and his party have both spoken strongly in terms of enhancing their relationship with India. So we reciprocate that interest, that commitment, and therefore this visit. Now, the program essentially has 5 pillars, the government-to-government discussions, this would be between the 2 prime ministers, both at 10 Downing Street as well as at the Chequers, which is the official residence of the British Prime Minister. There will be an address at the UK Parliament. There will be business engagements, a meeting of the CEO Forum, of the 2 countries, which has been reconstituted, as well as an important address to the finance and economic sectors of UK. Prime Minister would be having a lunch with Her Majesty the Queen at Buckingham Palace, and there will be an engagement with the Indian diaspora. Prime Minister will also be visiting the JLR factory at Solihull, which is actually, in a sense, the flagship Indian investment in UK. He would He has a number of other engagements which include a visit to the house which Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had occupied when he was a student at the London School of Economics, as well as the unveiling of a bust of Sri Basaveswara right at the Thames River embankment. Just in terms of some sort of, I would say, special gestures or elements of this visit, I think you have the stay in Chequers is a little unusual. Other prime ministers have been there, not recently. The speech which the PM would give at the UK Parliament, to my understanding, would be the first time that an Indian prime minister would be speaking there. Prime Minister Cameron would be with him for most of his program, and in fact would be escorting him to the House of Commons chamber. When the Prime Minister, I didn't mention this earlier, would be paying homage at the statue of Mahatma Gandhi near the Parliament, which was inaugurated last year, and we expect a flypast with our national colours coinciding with that. We expect a very significant community event. In terms of I think most of the other program elements I've covered. In terms of the bilateral relationship with the UK, it's been a strategic relationship now for 11 years, since 2004. UK and India are actually leading investors in each other's countries. UK, our ballpark figure for UK investments in India is in excess of $22 billion. It amounts to 9% of the current FDI level in India. It's much harder to get a figure for Indian investments in UK, but I think the working assumption is this is somewhere in the $500 million, $600 million range per year for the last few years. We have 122 Indian FDI investments in the UK. We are a significant job creator there. In terms of trade, again, UK is a significant partner. We have almost $18 billion worth of trade. We export about 14 is the trade in goods, of which we export 9 plus. We import about 5, and we have a trade in services about $4 billion plus. As I mentioned, we have a very robust partnership in science and technology, education, healthcare, culture. We have 800 Indian companies operating in the UK. So this is broadly the state of the relationship. Now, in terms of what the discussions would be, there would be a lot of political and security related discussions, both on global and regional issues, including on countering terrorism and extremism. We will try to deepen the economic engagement. There would be, again, a lot of focus, particularly as there's growing interest in the reviving Indian economy. I think the message of the fact that it's getting easier to do business is resonating. You will see business agreements, some of which would be announced at the business event during the visit. I think the Prime Minister's speech at the economic event is also something which is eliciting a certain amount of interest. There will be a number of outcome documents. There will be mostly we do joint statements at the conclusion of all important visits. But in addition, we expect a statement on defense and security partnership, one on development partnership, because today both India and the UK operate provide ODA, do projects abroad. So we see some advantages in working together there. There would be a statement on energy and climate change, and possibly some sort of a broader statement, a vision statement sort of thing in addition. So that's essentially the context in which the visit is taking place, broadly what you can expect from there, and I'd be happy to take a few questions.